Hi Pisces, this is your next 7 days reading. I'm going to look at your energies in this time period from 13th September, I was going to say August, 13th September to the 20th of September. What's coming to you, you know, Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus sign. Very recently I had posted your love reading. If you haven't gone through that, you can look at it, listen to it. But this reading is about general life, about what's going to happen generally in your life. So Three of Wands is in the environment. You are expecting some answer, result, some kind of information in this time period. You are waiting for what you have worked upon. So you are waiting for someone or something. You could be in a distance from something. With the Five of Swords and the Six of Pentacles coming together, this can mean that you had a recent setback with something, or in this week you will hear something which will not be up to your expectation, but that is not going to change you as a person. So with the Six of Pentacles, you are going to be as generous as you were. You will remain as reciprocative towards others as you were. So there will be a empty victory or some kind of feeling of betrayal, but with the Six of Pentacles, you are going to remain generous in this time period. With the Nine of Wands coming twice, clarifying this means that you are not someone who gives up, number one. Number two, you have the courage to keep moving forward in your life, and you are going to do that. However, you will feel a little overextended or exhausted in this time period. You could be also going through a bout of negativity or some kind of you know, worry or anxiety. It could be a small illness in this time period, but you are going to improve very soon, within the week. With the Sun card and Six of Cups, it is saying by the middle of the week you are going to feel better. You are going to reminisce your childhood, or you could be expecting a friend who could be talking about childhood, your student days, your early days. And with the Sun card, you will be able to experience joy, happiness, and innocence of love. So things will work out for you. In terms of your family or children can give you happiness. You can also feel better in your health in this time. So with the Wheel of Fortune coming in the middle of this reading, it's saying that there will be an entry of a prosperous person or someone who quickly changes your mood. And this person could be Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, or could be having air energy in their chart. With the Wheel of Fortune, Knight of Swords energy, you yourself could be moving forward or going for a quick journey, and something that you were expecting will work out, and you will come out of Five of Wands, and you will feel Ten of Wands. So the final leg will be over. Suppose you are giving some examination, or if you are going through some rounds of interviews, the draining period will be over. The competitiveness or the obstacles will be over. With the Knight of Swords, an information from someone will change your perspective. Things will fall in place. You will feel better. So underlying energy is of healing. So whatever betrayal energy, small betrayal energy or difficulty or some kind of worry, tension, or you know, where you felt like giving up but you didn't give up, that energy is going to help you. You are going to negotiate peace, you are going to show patience, and you know, ultimately things will balance out for you. Some information will come to you, talking with someone will give you some kind of promise. Page of Wands is ensuring that you could be getting some good news, enthusiasm, inspiration, or a short trip that's going to liven you up. So you will be defending against problems for definitely, and you will be on the higher ground with the Ace of Cups. Cure feeling of innocent love, renewals are going to take place in your life. So your outcome energy is the Hierophant and Queen of Wands. So this tells us that someone's advice, maybe a doctor, lawyer, banker, someone's advice or some process that works out for you gives you a loan, or it gives you a news of prosperity, it gives you news of a journey, achievements by your children or yourself, name, fame, recognition of some sort. It gives you some kind of propulsion in life with the Queen of Wands. You will be able to direct your energies towards something you want to achieve, and achiever tendencies will come inside of you. With the Hierophant, it could be your own knowledge or other people's knowledge, or it is asking you to change your perspective, pursue some spiritual interest, or take the higher road in your life to get out of energies of Devil and the High Priestess. This is, slow moving energies, mysterious energies, or some kind of chronic illness, or some kind of genetic problem, or some kind of issue of money, issue of entrapment in a love, or bad sexual encounters, or bad addictions, or something that troubles you. You will be able to come out of that with the Hierophant and the Queen of Wands energy. So you are going to have a victory over a situation because of someone's advice or because of some higher authority taking charge of a matter, and that will give you a movement. So Queen of Swords energy is an energy that is around you, which is your obstacle. So someone will bluntly or directly say something which you will not like, or someone could be very rude, which will put some bad energies in your heart, or negative thinking. Aquarius, Libra, Gemini energy. Knight of Wands energy is your advantage. This is movement, shift, change, and getting inspired to pursue your passion. That is going to give you a change of your scenario, and you are not just going to sit around, you are going to change your gears, getting inspired to move forward. So some orders, some words will put that fuel inside of you, and you are not going to take things just by leaving them. You will take action. So you could be doing lot of work, toil and labor card is coming, which is like working for something which does not give you good compensation. There could be a marriage situation where you have to work hard or make effort, or a love situation. Pathway is opening up for you, some new information, some new clarity regarding your darkened path is coming to you. So light will be seen at the end of the tunnel. You could be talking to, or you could be someone who wears a uniform, or you are going to get energy or help from a uniformed person, could be an official figure. So rules, regulation, restrictions of someone could be bothering you, or it is going to help you. The journey card is telling me that you are going to get a reprieve from a situation by taking your backpack and moving, or taking your suitcase and moving somewhere. That is going to give you an energy of change, and that is going to change your mood as well. So I have got some I've got two cards from the Heaven and Hell Oracle, and I have taken the Angel cards, the Heaven cards. So first card that has come out for you is the Melahel, you know, card, the God who deflects evil, the God deflecting evil. And the Lord shall persever thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth and even for evermore. That is what it says. People born, so we are not talking about people born under Melahel's influence, but we are talking about Melahel's help. They influence courageousness, and they give the influence of accomplishing honorable actions. Melahel protects against weapons, gives safety in travel, and governs water and produce of the earth, especially plants necessary for the cure of disease. So some of you could be taking herbal medicines, some of you could be journeying over sea and water. Some of you will be protected in this time period, and Melahel is going to deflect evil in your life. The other angel card that I have got for you is Vyuhalia, or the God of Virtues. So the God, King or ruler kind of energy. It says, but unto thee have I cried, O Lord, and in the morning shall my prayer prevent thee. So it is about military and glory. Someone will influence you, or you will have rapport with the angel of war and become famous through the use of arms. So, you know, this reading could be going to people who are uniformed, or they have, they carry arms. Vyuhalia may be called upon for destruction of an enemy and deliverance from bondage. So this could be, someone who is working for the forces. This could be for someone who is in the security systems. This is for those people, or this is telling us that we can call upon our angels and get some strength out of these energies. So the final card, the angels and ancestors card, here is telling us that you can intend and create. High priest energy is coming to you. So recognize that you have the power to change your life. Face your fear and align with light. You are a bridge between heaven and earth, and it's important for you to know that you are more powerful and connected than you may think. Everything you are giving attention and energy at this time is creating your way forward. There have been some setbacks, but accept these as experiences that have led you to a deeper understanding of yourself and your spirit. Know that you are being guided by the ancestors to direct your thoughts and energies towards what you want to grow, heal and expand. So you are going to heal, you are going to expand, you are going to get some advice, you are going to get out of tired or exhausted energies, and quickly your situation is going to change this week, Pisces. So if you have liked this reading, please like and subscribe. If you have something to say to me, write it in the comment box. People who are going through issues can contact me for a personal reading. These readings are prepaid, pre-booked and pre-slotted. So decide and then contact me. And people who watch me and who have been my ardent followers, please do share my readings with others so that the expansion of the audience base happens. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.